¿Te preguntaste alguna vez qué ocurre cuando los policías racistas se encuentran por fin con la persona equivocada? Cuando se encuentran cara a cara con alguien que se niega a retroceder, que no tolera más la injusticia. He aquí 7 casos en los que se invierten los roles y quienes abusan de su poder se ven obligados a afrontar las consecuencias de sus actos. En un incidente preocupante en un Starbucks en Castro Valley, California, el 20 de septiembre de 2019, la parada de rutina de una familia negra se convirtió en un calvario angustioso cuando fueron detenidos injustamente por los agentes del alguacil del condado de Alameda. Ashley Lugervale y sus 2 hijas, que acababan de detenerse para tomar un café, se encontraron esposadas y sometidas a un registro de su coche, bolsos y teléfonos móviles bajo sospecha de robos de automóviles con los que no tenían nada que ver. A pesar de su firme y tranquila insistencia en su inocencia, fueron detenidas sin motivo.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
What are you guys doing here?
Waiting to go to Starbucks in a second. Why? Oh, we have. Is there a problem?
Well, actually, let me tell you why I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I've been having auto break-ins in this parking lot every morning around this time.
Thank you very much.
So I've been driving around here.
Okay.
And I noticed that. You guys aren't doing nothing but hanging out.
Yeah, I just got here from
and
Vegas.
So, okay, well that
this morning. I've been driving all night.
Okay.
It takes 8 hours to get here.
Well, relax. That's my reason why I'm talking to you.
I'm here. We're in a car from the Bay Area, from Oakland.
Okay.
Just because it's got Nevada plates.
It's not a Nevada car.
I'm not Nevada.
Do you have your ID on you?
Okay, so wait a minute. Now, why are you asking for my ID? You just explained to me about the break-in.
Right.
But why did you explain to me about my ID? What's that about? What did I do? What kind of crime did I commit?
What kind of crime did you commit?
Yeah, I'm asking you for my ID.
Yeah, you have to give me your ID.
Why do I have to give you my ID?
Why?
I don't have to give you my ID because I haven't did anything. You started talking about a break-in.
Okay.
I thanked you for informing me that.
Right.
I informed you that I'm resting because I'm about to go into Starbucks, right?
Mm-hmm.
I informed you I've been driving all night, right?
Well, Starbucks has been open for about 2 hours.
It's actually been open since 5. I checked my GPS.
Okay.
Are
you doing anything wrong?
No, I'm not.
So then what's the big deal?
I don't have to give you my ID. I'm not doing anything
wrong. You do.
No, I don't. I know the law. I don't have to give you my ID. I'm not doing anything wrong. I have not did anything wrong.
So what you're doing now is leading me to believe that you might be doing something wrong.
No, I'm not doing that, so don't try to trump up no charges. I saw get your phone down, start recording. Start recording right now, honey. Get Anika on the phone.
Why are you getting so worked up?
Because I gotta have protection. Because I don't know where this is about to go. Gotta have protection.
Well, it's not gonna go anywhere if you cooperate.
Anything.
El agente cuestiona su presencia debido a los recientes robos de coches en la zona, pero la madre afirma su inocencia y se niega a facilitar su ID, alegando que no está implicada en ninguna actividad delictiva. A medida que aumenta la tensión, la madre comienza a grabar la interacción como medida de precaución ante una posible escalada, lo que pone de relieve la desconfianza y el miedo que a menudo sienten los negros durante los encuentros con la policía.
So you see this thing right here?
We're not doing anything.
So this is my camera. Everything's being recorded.
Exactly, and I'm not doing anything. That's what did you hear me tell my daughters? Start recording as well.
They can record all day.
Yeah.
So why are you making this a big deal?
Because I haven't done anything.
You said you're a local resident, or you're from here.
I said I'm originally from here.
Okay.
That's what I just told you.
Well, this can be a completely positive encounter.
Exactly.
Okay?
I'm not going to give you my ID because I haven't done anything. Call Anika right now.
Do you have a valid driver's license?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. I wouldn't be in this car if I didn't. I can't rent a car without a valid driver's license. Yes, I do.
Okay. Well, I don't know that if you rented this car, right?
Well, what does that have to do? Did we crime?
No, we didn't.
Okay.
No.
So are you going to refuse to give me your ID?
I am, because I haven't done anything. Call your superior. Call your supervisor.
I don't have to do that.
Yes, you do have to do that. Make sure you report that, because as soon as I leave here, I'm going to 150th, and I'm going to the sheriff's department.
That's
and what is your name? Give me your information.
I'll give you a card when we're done.
Yeah, exactly. You got it? Okay, good. I'm going straight there. Straight there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so.
We're being harassed for nothing.
It's not harassment.
Yes, it is harassment. Yes, it is. I have not done anything.
Okay, hold on. Could you explain to us the situation about the break-ins? We told you we just got in town, and you're still trying to tell us about an ID for what?
Right.
We haven't done anything. Did we break into something?
No.
Okay.
No. So a call to say that this car broke into something? No, it didn't.
Someone tell you this is a car you need to look out for.
Okay.
Exactly. No one did.
Well, guess what? I'm not in any rush. I can hang out here till you want to give me your ID.
I'm not. I want you to call your sheriff. I want you to call me or call your superior, your supervisor. I'm asking for a supervisor right now.
Well, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on.
Call 911.
What is going on
police.
Here?
I'm going to call the police.
No, no, we're not doing that. Okay, everyone in this car is detained. You can go back in the car and wait, or you can go in handcuffs and go in my car.
She's not gonna go. I tell her just get in the car. We're not detained. Yeah. I'm calling the police right now on you. I'm calling the police on you.
What kind of?
Because you came up here and harassed me.
This is why the police.
Exactly.
Yeah, everyone in this.
We haven't done anything.
Just sit in the car.
Hi, I just need to get a police officer immediately to the Starbucks in Cache Valley. I'm being harassed by an individual that's saying that they're a sheriff.
Contact.
For no apparent reason. For no apparent reason.
You can't even detain.
Yeah, I don't even know if they are or not. I was sitting in my vehicle. I had dozed off for a second, was going to go into Starbucks, and
negative,
all of a sudden I get a knock on
cell
my
phone.
Window. Of break-ins, and I'm like, what? And then I was like, okay. Mm-hmm. I saw it.
Okay, sit in the car or you're going in handcuffs. I'm not dealing with this.
I'm going in handcuffs and I have to use direction.
You can sit, you can sit. You can sit in the car. You can sit in the car.
What am I doing?
Last option, last chance. Sit in the car or you're going in handcuffs.
Y entonces, llegó el momento. El agente, haciendo uso de la fuerza, la esposó y la metió en el coche patrulla sin motivo alguno. Ella literalmente no hizo nada malo, pero debido al perfil racial, él le hizo esto.
We got two of them out of the car just running all around,
right
filming us.
This is my
PD investigation.
I have an individual
here.
Hello?
Hey,
I am in Castro Valley Starbucks. I just spoke with somebody and I got hung up on. Okay, here comes another car.
You don't have an answer. Sir, do you have an answer to why she's been detained? How
Castro Valley
crime?
Boulevard.
We're just nothing. We're doing nothing.
Okay, they don't want to listen to us, so let's go ahead and detain these two.
No, you're not going to detain them. No, you're not going to detain them. We haven't did anything. We have not did anything.
Let's start the car. Get out of the car.
No,
get out of the car.
I'm rolling the window down.
Get out of the car.
No, I'm rolling the window down.
Get out of the car.
No, I'm not. I'm rolling the window down.
Get out of the car.
I'm rolling the window down.
Get out of the car.
I see it's rolled down.
Get out of the car. Get out of the car.
No, I'm not.
Get out of the car.
I haven't done anything. I'll get out. Just don't pull on me. I'll get out.
All right, get out of the car.
Call the police.
Get out of the car.
Get somebody here.
Get out of the car. Get out of the car. This is your last chance to get out of the car or I'm placing you.
No, you're not placing me under arrest.
Or I'm placing you under arrest.
I'm calling someone.
Get out of the car.
I am. You don't have to pull me. I'm getting out now.
Then get out.
Stop it.
Then get out.
Stop it. You're going to go. You're going to get in a lot of trouble.
That's fine. Stand right here. Stand right here. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back. You're being detained.
No, I'm not being detained. For what?
You're being detained.
For what?
Put your hand behind your back or you're going to go to jail.
No, I'm not going to jail. And you're not detained. No, We're getting an attorney right now. The minute. We haven't done anything.
Put your hands behind your back.
Don't worry. We're going to the sheriff's department right now.
We have two detained working on the
attorney. We're getting an attorney. We haven't done anything.
Walk over here.
I haven't done anything.
Walk over here.
I haven't done anything.
Face by face this car.
I have not done anything. Don't worry. I don't have no weapons on me. Don't worry. Don't worry.
You can't even answer me.
Don't worry. We're going to go to the sheriff's department. Don't worry. I
said put your hands behind your back or you're going to jail. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
You're gonna get fired.
You're
gonna
get fired.
You're gonna get fired.
That's fine.
You're gonna get fired. Just watch.
Have we committed?
Don't worry, Asala. We got a lawsuit. Don't worry, because we haven't done nothing. We got a lawsuit.
No, I haven't.
We have a lawsuit.
Wait,
don't worry, we have a lawsuit.
Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
Don't worry.
That's fine.
We have a lawsuit. Excuse me, officer. Can you make some sense out of this? We haven't done anything.
Alright. Walk with me over here. We're detaining a third.
We have a detainee. We have a detainee. All of a sudden, we're getting arrested. Wait a minute.
Is this car open? Is this car open?
We have a. Excuse me. We haven't did anything. So can you get your? I asked for. I don't have a weapon on me.
I'm just checking.
I asked for his superior, his supervisor. I asked for a supervisor.
Grab a seat.
This is not how things work, ma'am.
No, what are you talking about? We haven't did anything.
Kick your feet.
We don't demand what we do.
No, I'm not demanding anything.
Pues bien, imagínate que te esposan sin ninguna causa, sin ningún motivo, solo por una diferencia racial, y te conviertes en el objetivo de la policía. Una madre soltera delante de su hija, lidiando con tantas cosas. Pero espera, este oficial pronto se enfrentará a las consecuencias de sus actos. Un jurado federal ha determinado que los ayudantes del sheriff detuvieron injustamente a una familia negra en un Starbucks del norte de California, lo que ha dado lugar a un veredicto que exige una indemnización de $8.25 millones. Pues bien, este incidente en el que se vieron implicadas una madre y sus dos hijas fueron esposadas y sometidas a un registro de sus pertenencias sin motivo ni pruebas de delito. Bueno, si crees que esa madre se defendió, entonces está claro que aún no te has encontrado con este tipo. Se encontró a solas no con uno ni con dos, sino con tres agentes. El 21 de agosto de 2020, en Tiburón, California, se produjo un tenso encuentro entre la policía y el propietario de un negocio. Khalif y Awash, una pareja, estaban trabajando duro a altas horas de la noche en su tienda de ropa del centro, Yema, cuando la policía de Tiburón se les acercó y les exigió una prueba de propiedad. Imagínate el miedo que sientes cuando de repente, a altas horas de la noche, la policía te interroga sobre tu propia tienda. Afortunadamente, la situación dio un giro cuando un vecino blanco intervino, afirmando a la policía que la tienda pertenecía a Khalif y a Walsh.
Seen you open this late?
Yeah.
Are you just restocking?
No, I'm just doing our thing.
Doing your thing? What's your thing?
What's up?
Well, I've never seen anyone in the store
is
this late.
Is that a problem?
Okay,
no, just chill. Is that a problem?
No, sir, there's no problem. I've never seen anyone in the store this late. I wanted to come check in and make sure
there's
everything's
no
okay.
There's no problem going on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you guys restocking the store?
There's no problem going on.
Why are you here so late?
It does not matter.
It does matter.
To who?
To me.
Why?
Because the store's never open this late.
Is this your store?
No.
And then what? If it's not your store, what's the problem?
I'm making sure that everyone is okay
down
here.
There's no problem going on. So if you have a problem, you let me know right now if there's a problem.
I just want to know why you guys are here so late.
It does not matter.
It does matter to me.
It does not matter to me. So if you have a problem, you tell me right now if you have a problem.
I don't have a problem, sir.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to know why you guys are here so late.
It does not matter. That's what I'm telling you.
It does to me. Can you take a hand in your pocket, please?
It does not matter to me.
Okay. Why are you guys here so late?
It does not matter to me.
I don't care, sir.
If you have a problem, call your chief of police, call whoever you want to call.
My supervisor's already on his way.
Yeah, call him. Tell him to come talk
to me.
He's
coming. Or one of you own the store?
Huh?
One of you own the store?
It does not matter. I'm not going to answer your question. If you have a problem, you tell me you have a problem.
I have a problem with you guys being here so late and you not telling me why.
Is it your store?
No.
So you call your supervisor, tell him to come here.
He's already on his way.
Okay, so when he's here, knock the door, tell me he's here. Is that okay?
Okay. Can you just tell me why you guys are here?
It does not matter. Call your supervisor, tell him to come here, and then...
Do one of you two own the store?
No,
or have any reason
do
to
not
be
talk
here?
To anybody else, talk to me. You're talking to me right now.
No, I'm talking to all three
you're
of you.
Not,
all
you're
three
talking
of you
to me,
store.
Sir. Okay? You're talking to me.
Las sospechas de la gente aumentan al comprobar que la tienda está abierta inusualmente tarde. Khalif, consciente del perfil racial, tranquiliza a la gente diciéndole que todo va bien y resta importancia a su presencia. Sin embargo, de lo que no se da cuenta el agente es de que Khalif está preparado para afrontar la situación de frente. Cuando llega el supervisor, Khalif se prepara para afrontar el encuentro con tacto y determinación. dispuesto a hacer valer sus derechos y a cuestionar cualquier trato injusto.
You're talking to me. Call your supervisor and let him come here.
He's already on his way.
Okay, so when he's here, you let me know.
No, why don't you come out here for me?
No, I'm not gonna. Do you have a problem with me?
I have a problem with you three being in the store right
now.
Is
this your store? That's why I'm asking you.
This town is my duty to protect.
This is, I live here. Do not tell me about whatever.
That's fine.
Okay.
Where do you live?
I do not. I'm not gonna answer your question. When your supervisor is here, you tell him to come talk to me.
Okay, he's already on his way. Can I tell him who
you
are?
So I do not have to talk to you.
You do have to talk
to me. No, I do not have to talk to
you. Yes, you do, because it's 1 o'clock in the morning and you're inside of a store and you can't tell me why.
It does not matter.
I would have done the same thing if you were over there at the candy store or wherever.
Dude.
Can you tell me who you are?
I'm not going to tell you who I am.
Why?
Because I'm not going to.
Why?
Because I'm not going to. Who are you?
My name is Isaac.
Isaac, and then what's your problem?
No se produjeron detenciones ni se presentaron cargos. Mientras, Gemma Khalif y su esposa, Hawi Awash, se veían sometidos a un perfil racial por parte de la policía mientras trabajaban diligentemente en su tienda de tiburón. Sin embargo, la pareja ha anunciado recientemente que ha llegado a un acuerdo con la ciudad. Tiburón ha acordado pagar a Khalif y a Wash $150,000 y poner en marcha cambios significativos destinados a fomentar la inclusión dentro de la exclusiva comunidad del condado de Marin. Además, el Departamento de Policía de Tiburón se ha comprometido a aumentar la frecuencia de la formación sobre prejuicios raciales, una medida que Khalif y Awash esperan que contribuya a crear un entorno más equitativo y acogedor para todos los residentes. El 13 de septiembre de 2021, en Richfield, Ohio, un día cualquiera, un agente del Departamento de Policía de Richfield paseaba por la zona y vio cómo se desarrollaba un drama en una gasolinera local. Por curiosidad, el agente decidió acercarse y charlar con uno de los implicados. Mientras hablaban, el agente decidió comprobar los antecedentes de la persona, para asegurarse de que todo iba bien. Pero las cosas se pusieron tensas cuando la persona insistió en que no tenía ninguna orden de detención, a pesar de lo que pensaba el agente. Entonces, la central dijo que había una orden de detención contra la persona en un centro penitenciario federal. Pero, ¿adivinen qué? La central se equivocó. En realidad, no había ninguna orden.
We're gonna be on show with the disturbance. What's going on?
Hey, man, me and my wife going through
some okay. He going through it, not me.
All right. What are we looking for, guy?
Cigarette.
All right. So what's the issue here that you guys are arguing in the parking lot of a gas station? Just arguing about first.
Yeah.
You guys drive? I'm assuming you drove here together?
Yeah, she was driving. I'm looking for my wallet. We got some wallet at home.
Okay. Just a verbal between two people. I'm still out.
Bueno, hasta ahora, la situación parecía tranquila y serena. Se puede ver al oficial preguntando a este hombre sobre la pelea que tuvo con su mujer, pero estaba claro que este hombre no iba a hablar sin una buena razón. Sin embargo, en cuanto el hombre se fue, llegó su mujer, y el agente empezó a hacerle las mismas preguntas, comprobando si necesitaba ayuda.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
All right, so
my license
and
registration.
Say what now?
You want my license and registration?
I don't need it, unless there's something you guys want to do.
No, me and my wife want this for right now,
I've been married for a long time, I understand.
All right, we're not so,
as long as you're okay and she's okay.
Here, your wallet right here, your thing.
All right, thank you.
Oh, okay. Just want to make sure.
Baby, where's my? I want skin. I want skin.
So what's the plan? Are we good? We just. Okay. Well, like I said, when I pulled in here, you guys were screaming at each other. You're telling me everything's okay. So is this? Are you guys gonna leave together, or what are you gonna do?
Yeah, I got it.
You're gonna leave together?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So you don't want any help from us, right?
No, I'm okay. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Very good. As long as you're okay.
I'm okay.
Bien, ahora, incluso después de haber conversado lo suficiente y haber comprendido que la pareja no necesitaba ayuda, el agente parecía seguir empeñado en perseguir al hombre y causarle problemas de alguna manera. Sin embargo, aquí hay un giro. Este hombre no era una persona más que obedece sin rechistar. En cuanto el agente se le acercó, vio con qué seguridad respondía.
Is that, that's your car?
Yeah.
How old are you? 55?
Yeah.
I got a warrant.
I got a warrant from where?
I don't know. I got to check on it.
So, check it out. Yeah. I mean, I just came from feds and I ain't got no warrants.
Saying you got one. Let me check it. Let me see it right there. I'll check on it. I'll let you know.
Yeah, I ain't got no warrants. I just came home from the federal penitentiary. I ain't got no warrants.
What are you in there for?
Possessing with the tent.
Okay. All right, let me check it out. I'll let you know in a second. Give me a second.
Bien, aquí el oficial pensó que sacaría la orden, asumiendo que el hombre se asustaría. Pero el hombre estaba tan seguro de su inocencia que inmediatamente le pidió a la gente que volviera a comprobarlo. Y entonces, ¡bam! Míralo tú mismo.
¿Qué pasó?
They were just fighting when I rolled up. I thought they were just talking and they started f***ing each other, so I jumped out.
Insane. Not a warrant. You're not arresting on this information.
Okay. I'm really messing up today. All right. There you go. Hey, stop. It came up. I'm telling you to stop. It came up. You had a warrant. I went and checked.
From where?
From the federal pen where you just got out of. So I went and checked for you. And I confirmed that it's not a release warrant. So you drop your attitude.
But you know you're throwing some.
I ran it and it came back a warrant. I checked on it for you, okay? Because you said you didn't have a warrant.
Give my goddamn ID, man.
How about I arrest you for obstruction? Here's your ID. Have a nice day. You're welcome to go.
Al final, no se presentaron cargos en este caso. Bueno, después de observar todos estos casos, no cabe duda de que individuos como él, que no han hecho nada malo, siguen encontrándose fácilmente esposados. En Hernando, Florida, algo impactante sucedió el 7 de noviembre de 2022. Acaba de salir a la luz un video que muestra cómo Tony Nguyen fue arrestado en Walmart, a pesar de no haber hecho nada malo. Todo fue un gran error. La gente de Walmart dijo que Tony era otra persona, un tipo llamado Cody Von der Linde, que no debía estar allí. Los policías les creyeron y se llevaron a Tony esposado. Pero adivina qué, se equivocaron de persona. Tony no era Cody, no causó ningún problema y ni siquiera se resistió. Afortunadamente, las autoridades se dieron cuenta de su error rápidamente y dejaron ir a Tony. Pero todo este lío plantea algunas cuestiones serias sobre cómo a veces se trata injustamente a la gente, solo por su aspecto.
¿A year?
Yes, you can't come back.
That was like 10, 15 years ago.
What are you talking about?
There's no limit on that.
When we are grocery shopping. What are you talking about?
You're trespassing, I swear. You're not allowed to be here, aren't you?
It said 10, 15
go.
Years ago.
No. Let's go.
Where are you taking him? What the? Where are you taking him?
Well, he wants you trespass as well, so let's go.
For what? For grocery shopping?
Right, hey, that guy right
no, goes for up. Being trespassed.
Look, for that, grocery
look.
Shopping?
Hey, look, record him right there. Look, record him too. That fat guy. That fat guy.
What is going on?
He a cop too.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Where are you taking him? Where are you taking him?
It's all right.
No, it's not. Where, oh my God, I cannot believe you're doing this.
Where
are you taking him?
Why are you pulling me, sir?
Where are you taking
him? Why are you pulling me? You don't have to pull me. You know I'm disabled, right? I have back issues. You don't have to pull me, sir.
Let go of him.
You don't have to pull. I'm walking with you. You don't have to
pull me. Let go of him.
I'm letting you know right now I have back issues. All right. I'm walking, so I don't know why you're pulling me, sir.
Oh my God. It's disgusting. Should be ashamed of yourself. I cannot believe you're doing this. Where are you taking him? What? Oh my God. Baby, I need the wallet. No.
Oh, yeah.
Where are the keys?
In my pocket.
I cannot believe you're doing this. You should be ashamed of yourself. I need the keys.
Step away.
Hold on, calm down. Just calm down. Just calm down. Just calm down.
I need the
keys.
Just
calm down. Hold on.
Oh my God. This is disgusting.
Sorry you feel that way.
Sorry I feel that way? No, that's a fact. You should be ashamed of yourself. What did he do? He has not done anything.
That's not true.
I didn't even take my medication yet. Can I at least take my medication first? Mm-hmm. I have blood pressure medication. I have anxiety medication. No problem.
Are you good to take his items for him? Hold on to them. Thank you. These are all his items, correct?
Desde el principio, Tony estaba desconcertado y se preguntaba qué había hecho mal. Su amigo se hizo eco de su confusión, pidiendo repetidamente explicaciones al agente. A pesar de sus súplicas, el agente guardó silencio, esposó rápidamente a Tony y lo metió en el coche. Pero la amiga de Tony, tan leal como siempre, se negó a guardar silencio. Durante todo el calvario, expresó su decepción e incredulidad. Sin embargo, la situación dio un giro inesperado cuando se encontró con que también la habían echado de la tienda Walmart.
You guys should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself. We are literally trying to grocery shop and Christmas shop. It's disgusting. Shameful. Shame on you.
Ma'am, what's your name?
It's L-A-U-R-E-N.
L-A-U-R-E-N. R-E-N, Lauren. What's your last name?
C-A-L-D-W-E-L-L.
What is your date of birth?
9/28/1980.
The manager here is requesting that you be trespassed from here. If you come back, you're subject to arrest. Do you understand that?
From Walmart?
From this Walmart. He's asking you to be trespassed.
But I don't understand why.
He doesn't have to have a reason. He's asking you to be trespassed.
I grocery shop here and purchase.
I understand.
I spend a lot of money here.
If you have a house and you don't want someone at your house, for whatever reason in Florida, you can have them trespassed. It's the same for Walmart. He's asking that you be trespassed. I'm giving
I've
you
done
a warning.
Nothing. I understand, it but I would like a reason.
You don't have to have a reason. To
really?
Florida.
I think that's
straight.
Crazy.
It is. It's the same reason you can have someone trespass from your house for no reason.
Yeah, but that's your residential.
So I'm giving, this is your
I
warning.
Understand.
Okay.
I'm just discussing it.
So the reason why he's going to jail tonight is because he's been warned in the past. There's no time limit on it.
You're taking him to jail?
Yes, it's called trespass after warning. He gave him a warning in the past.
When?
And he's back. I'm going to go double check that so I can have the exact date. Right now, he's being detained. He's not under arrest because I have a crime at hand. I'm going to see if the crime, if I have probable cause for the crime. Okay?
A crime? I mean, that's
trespass
such a strong
a crime.
Word. Oh my God.
It's a misdemeanor. It's not a big crime.
But you're talking about taking him to jail?
I'm going to verify that before I do. He's being detained right now, okay? So I need you to leave. You're being trespassed, okay?
Well, I'm not leaving him. We just came back from the Springs. We were in a Jeep. We have a boat. I cannot ride that. This is so upsetting. And I always support you guys, but this is disgusting. This is horrible. This is not fair. This is horrible.
Piensa en lo furiosa que debe sentirse esta chica. Que te echen de la tienda sin motivo alguno no está bien, es horrible. Pero no te preocupes, esos agentes recibirán pronto su merecido. No pueden salirse con la suya eternamente. La justicia los alcanzará. Recuerda lo que te digo.
So the trespass has been confirmed. He has been trespassed here actually this year. So he will not be staying here. He's going to be going to jail tonight. You'll have a bond. You'll be able to bond him out, okay? Does that understand? You understand that? You have all his items?
Right. This is horrible. We just came from the Springs. We're in this Jeep with a boat and a trailer.
I got you. But regardless, once
Does
you trespass
he know
from somewhere,
that?
I'll explain to him on the way that I just explained to him, actually. So. Is there anything that you need from me? All right. I need you to get in the car and drive away because if you come back here, you're going to also be going to jail for trespass, okay?
This is disgusting.
I'm sorry you feel that way.
I love you. I'll call Brittany. Can I speak to him?
It's up to him. Make it quick.
Let me call Mike.
Can I at least get my phone and take my medication first, sir? Because
You can't take any medications before going to the detention center. Whatever you need, they can get you there.
They have doctors and stuff there.
I'm literally going to go into seizure.
If you go into seizure, let me know. I'll have EMS come out.
Can I have my phone? Yeah, and call Mike. That's fine.
You can take your phone if you want. You can't use it.
No,
you can take it.
Yeah, I just need it for phone numbers. Yeah.
Right, they'll let you get numbers out of it.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, that's fine.
Can we give them your ID?
It's just that you
guys. Yeah, that's fine, whatever. That's not. Hey, have Mike come pick up my Jeep.
Do you want her to drive it away? Because she's also trespassed from here. She can't hang out here.
I'm going. I can drive it.
You sure?
I'm just going to go to Mike's house. Yeah. I'm going
to
call them.
Just drive into the next parking lot or something and then pull over and then have Mike come get it. Okay. Right. That's fine. Is that all right? Cause she...
That's fine.
Yeah.
That's fine.
As long as she leaves Walmart's property. All right.
Tras darse cuenta del error de identidad, el departamento del sheriff del condado de Hernando liberó inmediatamente a Nguyen. Sin embargo, el calvario no terminó ahí. El jueves, el abogado de Nguyen emprendió acciones legales presentando una demanda federal contra Walmart, el ayudante del sheriff implicado y el empleado de Walmart. La demanda reclama $10 millones por daños y perjuicios, poniendo de relieve las graves consecuencias de las detenciones ilegales y la necesidad de rendir cuentas en tales situaciones. Los adultos ya tienen que lidiar mucho con los perfiles raciales y ahora es terrible ver que los adolescentes también se enfrentan a ellos. Es simplemente repugnante. El 25 de marzo de 2017, en Grand Rapids, Michigan, 5 jóvenes de entre 12 y 14 años se encontraron en una situación aterradora. Recién llegados de jugar al baloncesto en el Salvation Army Croc Center, se encontraron de repente con policías armados. Los confundieron con sospechosos de una pelea y les ordenaron tirarse al suelo y registrarlos. Aterrorizados y confusos, obedecieron hasta que llegaron sus padres para confirmar su inocencia. Este alarmante incidente pone de relieve la angustiosa realidad de los perfiles raciales y las profundas repercusiones que pueden tener en vidas inocentes.
Kids that were leaving here, you thought you saw someone drop a revolver. You for sure it is.
Okay.
The kid was all black.
The kid was dressed in all black, and there was another kid who was trying to call him back, kind of light skin, curly hair. He had a red top and a black and red like Adidas sports jacket type zip up. And the kid who dropped it was in all black, and he was calling the other kid in the red and black to come back.
He dropped a revolver, you said? Yeah. Okay.
Kid in all black.
Yeah.
Okay. Was it the group of all the kids over
yeah,
there?
Yeah, they just walked around here not even 5 minutes ago.
Tras escuchar al transeúnte, los policías siguieron rápidamente a los adolescentes, pero lo que ocurrió a continuación mostró los riesgos de precipitarse con poca información. Es un recordatorio de que hay que ser precavido y pensar antes de actuar, especialmente cuando se trata de mantener la seguridad de los barrios.
Guys, get on the ground. Keep your hands out. Hey! Come over here. Keep your hands where I can see them and get on the ground. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Just keep your hands out, okay? Ma'am, can you go back in your house for me? Ma'am, go back in your house. Go back in your house now. We're giving you directions, okay? Just follow our directions and we'll be all right, okay? How do you want to destroy?
En cuanto los chicos oyeron las instrucciones de los policías, obedecieron sin vacilar, tirándose al suelo. Sin embargo, el sonido de sus gritos asustados revelaba lo asustados que estaban. Parecía que los policías estaban siendo un poco demasiado intensos, causando aún más angustia a los niños.
Okay. Just calm down, calm down. Calm down, okay? We'll be right.
Right there, right?
Right back to me.
Just keep on coming back, man.
This to be possibly in the wrong place at the wrong time, matching the clothing these kids have. Okay?
Like you said, your son is fine. He's 110% fine. I just want to
submit the college call on the 28th of September.
I don't mean no disrespect, but y'all got to understand.
I understand, but you have to understand.
That's my baby right there.
Listen, you have to understand our position as well. We have to
investigate. Yeah, but when a mother come and just say, show me, just show me.
But the way you were acting, I couldn't.
I can't help it. That's my baby.
I understand. I'm a parent as well.
I never. We don't deal with police. I don't never even have no charges. We don't do this. All the stuff that goes on in this world, I worry about my kids every day. That's why I don't let them go nowhere. They'll ever do this. That's why I don't never let y'all go nowhere.
I didn't do nothing.
You don't understand the way I feel right now. It don't even matter whether you did or you didn't. You don't understand the way I feel right now.
Because a lot of people out here have guns. We're not saying that your kids had guns or anything like that, but we're just doing our job, okay? Officer Colgrove.
You saying you're not saying they had guns, but y'all pulled your guns.
I know, because we don't know that. We do not know that.
Exactly. Y'all didn't, they didn't have, y'all didn't see a gun, but y'all put guns on my kids.
Would you understand that where we're coming from, matching description, we're not just going to walk up to somebody, hey, do you have a gun on you? You know, we're just taking every precaution. No one got hurt in this. Everyone's been cooperative with us, okay? Okay. It's not like we're out here like,
just like y'all understand.
But we're not out here like we're
outside too.
Okay, but
my kids go to the Croc to play basketball.
I know.
That's it.
And they
plain and simple.
Wrong place at the wrong time, obviously, for these kids.
Okay. Right place at the wrong time.
I understand, but there was a big fight over there. I know, they were there when the fight was going on.
No se presentaron cargos, y el jefe del departamento de policía de Grand Rapids, David Rajensky, se disculpó por el incidente, reconociendo la angustia que había causado. Expresó su pesar por la confusión y aseguró a la comunidad que se esforzaría por evitar este tipo de situaciones en el futuro. Después de ver a todos los demás, no hay nadie como él. Se mantiene firme con una moral y unos valores fuertes, defendiendo su dignidad frente a dos o tres hombres. En una sorprendente confusión, el 29 de enero de 2021, un hombre negro de 60 años llamado Eric Lindsay se vio envuelto en una tensa situación con agentes de policía de Westchester, Ohio. Las imágenes de la cámara corporal muestran el momento en que Lindsay, que estaba de compras, fue detenido e interrogado por agentes que en realidad buscaban a otra persona. Vestido con un llamativo abrigo naranja oscuro y una bufanda, Lindsay argumentó enérgicamente que no había hecho nada malo, señalando lo absurdo de la situación. A medida que la situación iba subiendo de tono, la frustración de Lindsay se hizo patente y denunció las suposiciones erróneas de los agentes. Todo el intercambio grabado por la cámara nos da una visión preocupante de cómo los errores de la policía pueden afectar a las personas, especialmente cuando se trata de la raza.
Hey, boss. Can you talk to me? Yeah. How you doing, man? Taking hands out of your pockets for me? How you doing?
Doing well until I got stopped. What's up?
Yeah, LP called and said that you were concealing some items inside your jacket.
Who do I sue?
Huh?
Who do I sue when you don't find Hey, come get this on film!
Well,
who do I sue?
You know, we're just trying to figure it out. Like I said, we got a call. That'll help you to call somebody. Okay, just say you've got a brown jacket on. Okay, jacket on me.
I walked in here 5 minutes after you guys walked in. I saw you walk in. So how could they see me still?
I have no idea.
Get this on film, please.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's what we're trying to figure out.
So what do you want? What do you want me to do?
If you have things to say.
What did they say? A black man did it?
No, sir.
Well, what did they say? Because I'm walking here after you guys.
Listen.
This isn't tan. What am I listening to? What am I listening to? This isn't tan. This is orange as It's not okay.
Sir.
It's not okay. This is as orange as Hell yeah, I got items in my jacket. The items that I walked in here with. Behind you guys!
Well, that's not what we're being told.
I don't give a f- you've been told! Hold on, man. I'm getting this one too.
Okay.
Exactly! Exactly! Get them straight, man! It's not okay! No, you won't! I'm getting the f- here when I get what I need. Get it. It's not okay.
Well, again, we're just going by what...
No, you got the wrong mother... Admit it! I'm listening!
My name is Offerman.
I'm listening.
Tras darse cuenta de que se habían equivocado al reaccionar Eric, los agentes redoblaron sus esfuerzos en la búsqueda. Finalmente encontraron y detuvieron al verdadero sospechoso, un hombre blanco que coincidía con la descripción dada. Pero el perfil racial al que se enfrentó Eric le molestó mucho.
I think
he's like, Adam.
What's
going on, Bob? Come here. Sorry. I am. I'm going to give it to you.
Okay, turn around.
Bring it back here. Oh, well, I'm just going to make sure. All right. How much stuff you got? You got a lot.
Justo después de esposar al verdadero sospechoso, tanto el encargado como el agente se disculparon con Eric. Sin embargo, la humillación pública que sufrió debido al perfil racial le perturbó profundamente.
Who was the one that was doing this reporting?
Our protection.
Didn't he say a white man or a black man? That's the first description that comes up. Because that's the easiest thing to be determined.
Yeah, so they were given a clothing description.
That I don't know.
He didn't have black pants on.
Right.
Well,
yes, sir.
You know how stupid you guys look.
I understand. You're upset. And I do apologize. Sincerely.
Alright.
Yeah,
that's
the
thing. I
hear you. Absolutely, yes.
Can you help find that? I can help. No, but there is a mess. I don't know if somebody dropped the furniture. And the
clearance section. All right. So we're going to go take care of this gentleman. If you have my information, if you need to talk to me any further or my supervisor, you can do that. And I can
your supervisor?
His name is Sergeant Niehaus. I can write his name down.
Let me walk around the corner, man. First thing he did was call me.
I'm a 60-year-old black man, works every damn day in my life, got a college degree and a master's degree. And walk in after they did, and I told them that.
I would be upset too.
The suspect did have a cutting instrument that he was using to cut items in retail. That's why I actually did.
And that's known procedure. They do that with everybody.
I get that.
Right. Yeah.
But I don't know. anything like him. Don't have anything. Whoever your asset protection guy was that reported this, you need to fire
him. Yeah, I don't know that information, and I will ask what description did he or she.
Yeah, she does.
So I get embarrassed in the public over being pulled over, essentially, over something that ain't, the guy doesn't even look like me.
Right. Right. Okay.
Again, my name is Tim. Mitkin Ball is my last name on there on the card.
Alright, yeah, I know you're hot and serious. I will need to go through.
This asset protection guy.
El Departamento de Policía de Westchester tomó medidas contra los agentes Mitkenbaugh y Sanders y les expidió advertencias administrativas por infringir las normas del departamento. También se les ordenó que volvieran a recibir formación sobre la realización de entrevistas sobre el terreno, según consta en los registros policiales. Tras la detención del verdadero sospechoso, Brewer, el agente Mitkenbaugh, pidió disculpas a Lindsay. Sin embargo, un año después, Lindsay emprendió acciones legales presentando una demanda contra Major, el Departamento de Policía de Westchester y los agentes implicados, Tim Mitkenbaugh y Tanner Sandes, que le habían parado e interrogado en la tienda.